Seated, everyone. Welcome, friends and family. Lots of beautiful, smiling faces with us here today, and we are so glad to have you with us. On behalf of Susie and Jason, I would like to thank you all for being here this afternoon, for taking the time and making the long journey here to join with them in celebrating this special moment in their lives together. Susie and Jason have invited you here to this beautiful place to show you a glimpse of an important piece of their love, to share with you the beauty of Northern Michigan, which they've enjoyed together and with many of you here now over the years. Today is the beginning of a remarkable journey for this couple, drawing on their mutual admiration, respect, and trust. They are ready to embark on the next chapter in their lives. Susie and Jason are lucky to have found each other, as there are few greater joys in life than finding someone with whom we truly click. In that spirit, I'll share a short reading on soulmates from author Richard Bach. A soulmate is someone who has locks that fit our keys and keys to fit our locks. When we feel safe enough to open the locks, our truest selves step out, and we can be completely and honestly who we are. We can be loved for who we are and not for who we're pretending to be. Each unveils the best part of the other. No matter what else goes wrong around us, with that one person, we're safe in our own paradise. Our soulmate is someone who shares our deepest longings, our sense of direction. When we're two balloons and together our direction is up, chances are we found the right person. Our soulmate is the one who makes life come to life. Marriage is a venerated institution and one deserving of deep reverence. Today we observe the union of Susie and Jason in matrimony, a commitment they have chosen to undertake with all the sincerity that it warrants. While marriage is a sacred and serious tradition, it is also cause for tremendous joy. Married life is full of surprises, adventures, and memory-making, all made possible by the enduring power of love. When Susie and Jason finalize this union, they will begin a new life of partnership, one defined by shared hopes, dreams, and successes. I'd like you now to please face one another and hold hands and remember this moment in time. Susie and Jason, as you live, learn to live as one. You will encounter many challenges that can help you grow. Spend time doing the things that make life precious. Cooperate with each other. Always make time to laugh together. Never lose appreciation for the love that you share. Remember, too, to adhere to the vows that you will make today. Seek strength from each other. Give hope to each other. And let your trials help you grow together. They say love can build bridges and climb mountains. And they're right. You will find that as it grows and matures over time, your love for one another will prove both fulfilling and empowering. Yes, there will be challenges, but the strength of your bond will offer you protection against life's storms. Always make your relationship a priority and continue to nurture each other. Through a commitment to love, together you will be able to navigate any obstacles that come your way. Marriage is a bold step in an unknown future. It is risking who we are for the sake of who we can be. In marriage, two lives are intimately shared, and the blending of the two must not diminish either one. Rather, it should enhance the individuality of each partner. Marriage is not created by a law or ceremony. Rather, it occurs in the hearts of two human beings. It grows out of love, caring, and sharing ourselves with another. This ceremony is not magic. It will not create a relationship that does not already exist and has not already been celebrated in all the commitments Susie and Jason have made to each other, both large and small, in the days since they first met and recognized their connection to one another. So in witnessing this ceremony today, we are observing only an outward sign of an inward union that already exists between Susie and Jason. This ceremony is a symbol of how far they have come together, and a symbol of the promise that they will make to each other to continue to live their lives together and to love each other solely and above all others. The symbolic views that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it, every word. Susie and Jason, you will now speak your vows of love and commitment to one another. So Jason, please repeat after me. Today, surrounded by people who love us.
Today, surrounded by people that love us.
I choose you, Susie, to be my wife.
I choose you, Susie, to be my wife.
I'm proud to be your husband.
I am proud to be your husband.
And to join my life with yours.
And to join my life with yours.
I vow to support you, push you, inspire you.
I vow to support you, push you, and inspire you.
And above all, love you.
And above all, love you.
For better or worse.
For better or for worse.
In sickness and health.
In sickness and health.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Susie, please repeat after me your vows to Jason. Today, surrounded by people who love us.
Today, surrounded by people who love us.
I choose you, Jason, to be my husband.
I choose you, Jason, to be my husband.
I am proud to be your wife.
I am proud to be your wife.
And to join my life with yours.
And to join my life with yours.
I vow to support you, push you, inspire you.
I vow to support you, push you, and inspire you.
And above all, love you.
And above all, love you.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
In sickness and health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
You fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You both are choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, who makes you think, makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher, as you've learned much from one another these last few years. Now, you will say a few words that will take you across a new threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same. After these vows, you shall say to the world, "This is my husband, and this is my wife." So do you, Jason, keep Susie as your favorite person and wife, to cherish and respect her, to care and protect her, to comfort and encourage her? Do you promise to laugh with her, go on adventures with her, support her through life's tough moments, be proud of her, and find new reasons to love her every day?
Absolutely.
That works? Do you, Susie, keep Jason as your favorite person and husband, to cherish and respect him, to care and protect him, to comfort and encourage him? Do you promise to laugh with him, go on adventures with him, support him through life's tough moments, be proud of him, and find new reasons to love him every day?
I do.
Will you, Jason and Susie, be each other's partners from this day forward? Will you promise to bring out the best in one another, share your happiest moments together, and love each other absolutely for the rest of this lifetime and for whatever may come next?
We will.
You've both chosen to wear rings as a reminder of the promises you have just made to each other. People often say wedding bands are a perfect circle, with no beginning and no end. But these rings did have a beginning. The stones were formed a long time ago, deep within the earth. Eventually, a series of lucky events caused them to rise to the surface, where someone dug them up. Metal was liquefied in a furnace, molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful was made from raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of serendipity and effort, imperfect beings shape it into something extraordinary. It's the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. As you look at these rings over the years, I hope you remember that. Together, you've created something invaluable. And just as I know you'll protect these rings, I'm confident you'll protect the commitments you've made to one another today. Matt, may I have the rings, please? Jason, as you place this ring on Susie's finger, repeat after me. Susie, you are the love of my life.
Susie, you are the love of my life.
You are my very best friend.
You are my very best friend.
I give you my hand as I give you my heart.
I give you my hand as I give you my heart.
Unreservedly and unconditionally.
Unreservedly and unconditionally.
I give you this ring as I give you my love.
I give you this ring as I give you my love.
Exclusively and eternally.
Exclusively and eternally.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Good job.
Susie, as you place this ring on Jason's finger, repeat after me. Jason, you are the love of my life.
Jason, you are the love of my life.
You are my very best friend.
You are my very best friend.
I give you my hand as I give you my heart.
I give you my hand as I give you my heart.
Unreservedly and unconditionally.
Unreservedly and unconditionally.
I give you this ring as I give you my love.
I give you this ring as I give you my love.
Exclusively and eternally.
Exclusively and eternally.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Susie and Jason, no one but you can declare yourselves married. You have begun it here today in speaking your vows before your family and friends, and you will do it again in the days and years to come, standing by each other, sharing all that is sweet and bitter in life. Each tender act, each loving word will be the declaration of what was made here today. So it is now my joyful responsibility to officially acknowledge your union as husband and wife. Jay, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Susan Pryor.